Now, the first group of the instruction is called as data transfer group instruction. In a data transfer group instruction, we have to study total 13 instructions. And in the 13 instructions, the data, how the data can be transferred, that part we have to study. The data can be transferred from any one of the general purpose register to any other general purpose register, or from any memory location to any general purpose register, or from any general purpose register to any memory location. That means here data can be transferred from register to register, memory to register, or from register to memory. But the direct transfer of data from one memory location to another memory location in 8085 is not allowed, it is not possible. But you can transfer the data from one memory location to another memory location in the following way. From destination memory location, bring the data to any one of the general purpose register. And from general purpose register, you can transfer the data to the destination register. That means from the source memory, we can bring the data to general purpose register, and from that general purpose register to the destination memory location, we can transfer the data. Now the first instruction of this group is move R2 to R1. It is read as R2 to R1. It is read as R2 to R1. R2 is the called as source register and R1 is called as destination register. Here format is given, data from register R2 can be transferred to register R1. Only registers are used in this instruction, therefore addressing mode is register. 1 byte instruction and flags affected equal to none. In all the 13 instructions of data transfer group, from data transfer group, flags affected equal to none. What is the general explanation of this instruction? After execution of the instruction, the contents of register R2, it is called as source register, is transferred or copied to register R1, that is called as the destination register. It is copied. It is copied. Now, take one example. Here, let A is having the number ABH. That means accumulator is already having the number which is AB. A two-digit number can be stored in any one of the general purpose register. And B is having the number 98. B is having the number 98. After execution of the instruction, move B to A. Whatever the number, the contents of register B are copied to register A. Whatever the number is in accumulator, it is gets erased and the new number is overwritten in that particular mentioned register. Here in accumulator, the number becomes 98. That means B is also having the number 98 and A is also having the number 98. It gets copied. That means the contents of source register remains the same. Physically, data is not moved from source register to destination register. It gets copied. This part you have to remember related to the first instruction, move R2 to R1.